So glad that you're here, and I am absolutely thrilled to introduce to you Thomas Piercy, a clamimist and interior artist from New York City. Thomas just arrived yesterday, and he'll be staying with us for this week to work with our clarinet students in various settings. He already gave a master class this earlier today, which was a terrific experience for us all. I also like to thank our School of Music and Dance, as well as the Center for Research Studies, who generously sponsored his visit. In view of the program, which unfortunately didn't get printed, I will be talking just briefly about Thomas Piercy. So Tom is a critically acclaimed musician in orchestral, concerto, recital, and chamber music appearance throughout the Americas, Europe, and Asia. He has been described by the New York Times as brilliant, playing with refinement and flair. He has performed in the Emmy Award-winning Juno Baby CDs and DVDs, performing with pianist Earl Wild, Frederick Evelyn State, working with Leonard Bernstein, appearing on KRS-One music video, playing concerto in Japan, recording with members of the Maroon 5, premiering over 200 works composed for him, performing on Broadway, off-Broadway, television, radio, and commercial recordings. Studied at the Juilliard School of Venice School of Music, and clarinet studies with Gervais de Payer, Dr. Stephen Johnston, Leon Rushenov, and Colin Opperman. Featured his studies with Hitomi Nakamura. Tom will be introducing each work that he will be performing, and the program will feature a mix of Hitchiriki and clarinet. And the pianist today is Dr. Grace Choi, who is also the faculty of the university. So again, and I am the clarinet professor here for to introduce that. Thank you again, and hope you enjoy the program.
Thank you for coming to tonight's special for New York concert here at the University of Oregon. Thank you, Dr. Kim and University of Oregon for having me here. First part of the program is going to be music for Hichiriki, which is an ancient Japanese instrument mostly used in court and in temples. Only recently have composers started writing contemporary music for this instrument. Tokyo to New York was a series I started in Tokyo about 6 years ago, where I had Tokyo composers write music that then I would take to New York and perform. Very few Tokyo and Japanese composers are performed in New York, surprisingly enough, other than the one or two very famous ones. Then I had New York composers write music, and I took that music to Tokyo. So went back and forth. And in Japanese, the to, which looks like reading in English, oh, you don't have programs. It says Tokyo to New York. But in Japanese, it's Tokyo to New York, which is Tokyo and New York. So we were just going back and forth with the music. And in those 6 years, we've had music, everything from 18-year-olds up to now 96-year-old composers, students, some self-learning composers, some pop artists, J-pop artists, jazz musicians, and composers that have won such awards as the Pulitzer Prize, Grammy Award, Latin Grammy Award, and the Takamitsu Prize. And since then premiered over 100 pieces for Hichiriki or clarinet and piano with those composers. So I'm thrilled to bring that type of program to you here tonight. I'll say a little bit about each piece since you don't have a program. The first piece is Shinro, which translates to Deep Mist. It's by New York composer David Loeb, who is the head of composition at Mannes School of Music. But he spends for maybe the past 50 years, part of his each year in Japan, and he knows all about the Japanese instruments. And so he's written many pieces for traditional Japanese instruments. This piece, Shinro, was written after the earthquake and tsunami and disaster at Fukushima. And there were no trees left in that area. And this was his image of the souls or the winds and the mist going through what are no longer there, and also people searching for those lost souls. So the first piece, Shinro. Next piece is Dancing Piper, or Circling and Floating. And Isaji Sunao is the composer. Next piece is by Masatoru Goya, who's from Japan but now lives in New York. And this is called Tora Nagashi, which is a period in August of each year where it's not exactly a festival, but it's a week-long event where people invite the spirits of their loved ones and their family back. And at the end of the week, they light candles in lanterns, put them on the rivers and have them float away, and that is to symbolize their spirits floating back to the other world. This is Tora Nagashi.
Thank you. Next piece is called Clarinet Solitude by Yoki Yuasa. He's 88 years old now and still very, very active in Tokyo and still composing new pieces. This piece was written as a memorial for a good friend of his, composer Yoshiro Irino, after Irino had died. And the first time I played this was back in March at Tokyo Opera City Hall. And I purposefully did not ask Yuasa to come to the concert, because it was my first time playing it. Half hour before the concert, the very nice stage manager came back and said, "Oh, Mr. Piercy, there's someone here to see you." I went, "I don't want to see anyone before a concert, leave me alone." He said, "No, no, it's Mr. Yuasa." And I said some English words that I won't say here. I said, "Oh, okay." I was like, "Oh, Mr. Yuasa." And he said, I was like, "Now I'm really nervous to play it." And he sat about 4 feet from me during the concert. I guess he really liked it, because in November, he has asked me to play this piece in a special concert, contemporary music concert, at the National No Theater in Tokyo in early December. Then this is Clarinet Solitude by Joji Yuasa. And we will have the lights off, so be warned.
Thank you.
Next piece is called Your Kindness by Jun Nagao. He lives in Tokyo. He wrote this piece for a friend of his who died, and that his friend's favorite composer was Gershwin, and you'll hear a little bit of Gershwin in this piece. For those of you who play saxophone or are in wind bands, he has many, many incredibly good pieces for saxophone, saxophone piano, two saxophones piano, saxophone quartet, and many great wind band pieces. And he won the Takemitsu Prize maybe 12 years ago for a wind band piece. And so this is Your Kindness by Jun Nagao. Thank you. Next piece is Four Colors by Ned Roram. The movements are red, white, blue, and orange. This was written 15 years ago, his reaction to when the U.S. was getting ready to invade Iraq, and he was very much against that. He's a pacifist and feels very strongly about that. And the movements were sort of his feelings of red, which he subtitled that movement Strident. White is just a nice, simple melody. Blues, he considered a little bluesy. And then orange is the explosions that happen. This was premiered by me. It was written for me 15 years ago, premiered at his 80th birthday concert at Carnegie Hall. He turned 95 a couple of weeks ago and still going strong. He no longer composes. He says he's said everything he needs to say in music. So this is Four Colors by Ned Roram. Now for something a little different, after Piazzolla's Grand Tango, you may wonder why he's on a concert of Tokyo and New York composers. He's from Argentina, and they were having political troubles for many years. And as a very young kid, his family moved to New York and stayed there while he was a young kid and a teenager. Then he moved to Europe and was studying. He'd go back to New York, he'd go back to Argentina. He spent a lot of time in New York. Some of his most important recordings were done in New York, either in the studio or a very famous recording, Soledad, done at Carnegie Hall. And many of his people in his quintet moved to New York as well. Pablo Ziegler, who's the pianist in his quintet for many years, still lives in New York. His violinist, and many of the people that worked with him, studied with him. I've been lucky enough to play a lot of Piazzolla in New York with these musicians. And so we consider him, or New Yorkers consider him, a New York composer for this purpose. So this is the Grand Tango, Astor Piazzolla.
Thank you.
Next piece by George Gershwin, American in Paris. Before we play this, I'd like to thank you for coming to the concert tonight. Thank you, University of Oregon. Thank you, Dr. Kim. And especially thank you. I showed up yesterday, I think yesterday, maybe the day before, but we didn't rehearse. Rehearsed yesterday, and she made everything easy, even the hard stuff. So really appreciate that. Thank you. Thank you.